Hello everyone, welcome to Adburn Under Siege in Rimworld, Alpha 16. We've got the Black Crag, 22 of them no less. They're coming for us. We have to defend ourselves. Or we are screwed. Pretty severely. So yeah, that's gonna be fun. We have some decent shots, but it's gonna get hairy. There we go. We'll try and, like, orientate our people in a way that sort of makes sense. We're gonna be in big trouble. Peterson is gonna have to pick up the slack. He's gonna have to melee like he's never meleeed before. We could bring in the Muffalo. We only have two Muffalo at the moment. They seem to be pretty happy to ignore us. I like this turn of development. What can I say? They don't really seem to be going for us directly. I can live with this. Peterson is going to have to try and draw their fire while meleeing anyone who dares to come close enough. We'll probably lose some power installations. But we're doing a pretty good job. These tribals have... Oh god, Peterson, get out of there. Why are you walking so slowly, Peterson? No reason. He's just not feeling like it. Yeah, they're beating up our solar generator and wind turbine. We've taken out a pretty good chunk of them. We've got Hakuya as well, because we're taking casualties right now. Not losses, but casualties. It's a different thing. Lost a few people, actually. Not bad at all. But we're gonna lose our power over there in a minute. Oh, that's it. We're doing a pretty good job of wiping them out. Bud is able to hold the line for now. Colin lost his right eye. Oh my god! Dude! Head to bed, yeah. We're gonna get, Hakuya over there, treat his injuries. There go our power installations, which is pretty, well, we kinda needed those, let's just say. We put one down on their feet, that's good. They're fleeing! We have won! The day is ours! Definitely try and kill some more of them. That's a shield coming back. Hakuya, I would really... Manning. I forgot. We forgot all about Manning. Damn. Yeah, we've got injuries to take care of right now. And we're also trying to injure more of their people. Because, hey, why the hell not? If we can get one more kill. Maybe one more person to rescue as well. Wolverine? Yeah, capture. Do it. Go, quickly. What are our faction relations with them at the moment? Minus 37, so we need like 3 people. Well, that's number 2 then. Death in 9 hours. Yeah, we're gonna try and keep them alive. I know they're... jerks that keep trying to kill us. And they cost someone an eye. That is... not something I will forgive easily. But all in all, you know... we can get over this. I'm honestly just amazed we survived. Because they always have the weight of numbers, it's crazy. Peterson is bleeding heavily, but it's only 2 injuries. So, that's easy to treat. You need an eye. I know we still have an eye spare, so... Because I forgot about it for ages. You know, it does have its benefit. We now have an eye for Colin. Although that said, Colin, you've got the chemical fascination. I'm not sure if I, like, we'll probably have to give him an eye at some point, sure. But I'm not sure if we're willing to use, I don't want to say waste. That sounds terrible to the poor guy, but I'm not sure if we want to use an eye on him. Because he's not, you know, considered to be vital. Also, we're having big power issues right now. But Manning's able to keep Wolverine alive, that's good. We'll give him a friendly chat. Because, hey, that's how they, we can give them a friendly chat and not try and chat and recruit, and they will still improve our relations with him. You've got some okay gear. Like, we'll probably just let them go soon. Just to get their relations up. We still need to fight, like, one more raid, probably, before they stop being mad at us. But this is a good step. This is a good step indeed. Kangaroo, you die in 6.5 hours. Manning, it's your job to make sure that doesn't happen. As much as I despise them, these people are more useful to us alive. Whether as bags full of organs, or as relation boosts. Bud, treated. Peterson, treated. Colin, will live. Aquia, you need some attention after this. There we go. Kangaroo's gonna stay alive as well. Good job, Manning. Our boar is actually helping out with hauling, so that's cool. I would love to haul more of these weapons inside. Looks like we're gonna be doing just that. We'll be able to earn a pretty penny from sunning all of them. And we need to get rid of those trees so that we can actually move at a decent pace over here. We'll put some sandstone tiles down at some point. I'm sure. Just need to get them first. But hey, I did order people to start doing sandstone block making here again, so yeah, that should be happening now. Good. Right, we still have our two... you've lost things to frostbite. I blame the fact that we had a raid to fight, otherwise I would have, you know, taking you to the appropriate places. Yeah, are you nearly done? I'm trying to rescue her here, and you're trying to feed her. That's not how this is supposed to go. Let me just say that. Hold that door open. I need it to be 20 degrees inside. You know, 20 degrees is nice and hot. Right now it's not. One shield? Yeah, you're fine. No hypothermia on those people. Good! And this is now getting colder, so they should live. Unfortunately, Tony has lost a toe and a finger. Because, hey, I was distracted trying to keep the other colony alive. Which makes sense, right? It's a sensible thing to do. I might have to put traps all the way over here, I'm just gonna be honest. These people are jerks. Everyone, one has run out of food. Yeah. We're gonna have some trouble with that one for a while. Speaking of food, we've got enough here. But it's gone berserk. Alright, nobody's going in there. So he's leaving the door. Of course he's going outside, Bud, I swear to God. We have to beat you down, I will. Don't hurt our boar. Don't hurt anyone. Why is that door open? It shouldn't be. Oh well. We'll wait until these guys are healed up at the very least. Then we'll let them walk. Of course, we'll strip them for the clothing. We're not stupid. Not yet, anyway. Paradise working on Science Hotel. And suddenly you can cut the tree down. Beautiful. Jesus Christ, Bud. Are you literally gonna harass Colin in his bed? He's nearly dying. That's it, he's feeling great. Look at that. He killed someone. He witnessed death with a bloodlust. Yeah, he's feeling great. If you could not feel so horrible, that would be great. Yeah, things are a bit complicated right now. Also, expand roof area. We're gonna roof this. Yes, of course we are. Keep the snow outside. Preferably. You guys still... Yeah, you're feeling better. Good. We did get a bunch of extra medical training from all the hypothermia. Unintentionally, I might want to add. That was not the goal there. Ooh, Missy's actually doing some cooking. Good. We're making all the pemmican. We also got 1,000 kibble, 1,000 haygrass, which is pretty good. Pretty good. More than I was expecting, to be honest. Bud is still a bit mad, but hey, hopefully he'll get over it soon. That would be great. Anna isn't really able to train her social any further without a neurotrainer, so that's okay. Again, we'll just let them heal, then we'll let them go, because we are not monsters. Not yet, anyway. Yeah, leave that light on for now. You may want to not go near Bud at the moment. He's not himself when he's hungry. So, in the spirit of that, I'm going to have you temporarily cut down trees. I want to get rid of that pine tree. It's slowing us down so massively, it's stupid. It should go. There we go. Thank you. I appreciate it. What a sandstone tile then. Oh, we already have, apparently. Cool. This is now all considered roof, but it's still a bit angry at people. Manning, just stay in bed right now. It's the best I can tell you. You're a bit tired. Oh god, Bud is gonna be in here and he's gonna break. Bud, why are you walking around Manning's room with a gun? I know you're upset, but Jesus Christ. You're overreacting a little bit. Alright, let's see. You are still in shock, you've got a lot of pain. They're gonna walk away at some point, so we will have to capture them. Actually, that works. That is a -7. Yeah, not the best. We're gonna put a sandstone wall here. Colonist needs rescue. Bud, yeah. You know, I don't feel bad for you, Bud. I really don't. You mess with Manning, and that's what you get. You fool. Should have seen that one coming miles away, Bud. You're lucky you got off that way. I've seen people die when they break. Poor Bruno, for example. Who is no longer with us. I mean, you guys will get up eventually, but it would be way easier to just capture you now. Yeah, we're gonna turn these into... Yeah, sorry, Dan. This is now a prisoner room. That's your new lot in life, Dan. Hey, Nelly, you're doing construction. Great. Schlieffen is actually doing mining. I should have used a mining neurotrainer on you. But on the plus side, you've got an easy chance of learning it. So learn it, you will. There we go. Now this is considered a bed again. And I think we'll just capture... Oh! Since you rescued her, Tony's joined your group. Oh, okay, hello. That's a 3 out of 4 now, by the way. I just want to point that out. Not sure why she eventually decided to swing around? Welcome. Yeah. And in that case, we'll rescue D.Va again. Because, you know, we're amazing people. You should totally join us. Stuff is dying there because of the cold. Okay, you did get treatment. This colony always ends up being a bit of a mess when things are going wrong. There we go, we'll add a little bit of security there. Really screw that. I'm gonna go for the... so better style that I'm familiar with. There we go. Put some sandstone walls there. Put some sandbags in between, and we can shoot in between sandbags. Cargo pods. Huh. There we go. Let's see, what do we get? Devil Strand. Not bad. Sugar, could you be a deer and haul them for me? That is worth some silvers. One shield. That is now your bed, apparently. Poor Dan. He doesn't even know where to sleep, man. Get some extra beds in there, just temporarily. People need to stop sleeping outside and start sleeping inside. It It's actually the full 20 degrees in here. Wow. Mine a compacted steel bit there. Actually, I'll have Von Shield do it. Because Von Shield needs to learn. He loves it, so he needs to be better at it. Forever. Oh, by the way, we need to start making more beautiful power lines here. We actually cannot do that right now. We'll start by running one down there. That seems like a decent deal. Mine for me, buddy. Please. Smooth out a little bit. Tony's resting in a bed. Hey, you're feeling a lot better. We've got an extremely impressive dining room. Wow. Cool. I'm not sure what the size is, but... Oh, impressiveness. 129, apparently. Wealth is rich. Space is extremely spacious. It's pretty. It's slightly dirty. Still slightly dirty. Damn it. James. Clean the rock rubble. Damn it, it's still slightly dirty. Oh well. It's a very pretty dining hall. We're gonna make it even better. I want the best dining hall. Thanks, Tony. It's considered clean now. That's even better. Cool. Yeah. I like having an extremely impressive dining hall. What can I say? You gotta make an entry. You gotta make an impression, you know? Miscellaneous. Orbital trade beacon. We can make this room even bigger. Like, it's gonna be amazing. The best bloody trading room you will ever see. That's gonna be a big one, so we need to do a lot of digging for it. Right now, the entrance hall's doing fine, but it's not a permanent solution by any means. Let's get some more dining chairs in here. This needs to be a more impressive room, clearly. And James knows it. Come on, James, you're level 18 construction. Diva has joined the group. We got a 4-4 there. Oh yeah. Everyone decided to join our group without fighting. So in total, we now have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 people in Adburn. Thirteen people in Anchorage. And then 3 people currently on the world map in caravans. So that's a total of 24 people. I mean, sure, they might not have been the best people, but they're free. Like, we literally just got them without much effort. They're gonna be able to help out. They're gonna be, oh, there we go. You need 8 days to travel. You've got 6 days of food. I'm gonna split Pina off, because Pina's a lot faster. Pina, what do I want you to bring? They'll have 8 days of food. I kinda want you to have at least 1 day of food, though. Actually, let's go, like, make sure you have at least 4. We'll give you 5 days of food, why not? Because they all have, like, 6 days worth. You've got 5 days, so you should be very hungry once you get back, but you shouldn't be starving. Oh, and we'll definitely bring some stuff with us. Not that we need it, but damn do I want to. We've also got Luciferium. Huh. Yeah. Sure, why not? Wow. Right, that's 5 days worth of food on Pina. You know what? I'm gonna go down to 4 days. I think she'll be fine with 4, because she travels a bit faster. Why do you guys split up over oh my god. Caravan 2. Oh, that is Pina. Sorry. You guys only need 8 days. You know, the intent here was that they would be a lot... Pina would get there faster, but Pina... Which doesn't make sense, but oh well. They should all be fine without any starving. Ooh, an excellent chair. Good job, James. The Armadillo. There's an image of Ren Peterson gamboling in bed with Pina, with few clothes in sight. Oh dear. Peterson is touching Pina aggressively. The subjects are in front of a river, while the work is shaded in hues of blue and blue. Relates to Peterson and Pina becoming lovers on the first of spring. Well, clearly, I imagine Pina has been telling some stories now about Peterson, the master of war. I'm never gonna get over that. You're gonna keep hearing it forever. I love it too much. Please make some art relating to that, James. That would be totally amazing. Perkins is no longer psychotic. Huzzah. An excellent chair. Honesty. Engraving portrays a desert. There's a community in the distance. The pixelated style of the central scene clashes with the Romanesque depiction of the background. Nice going, James. And a good chair. You know, that's fine. I was like, I want a more impressive room. James was like, here you go. Cool. People are going to love the hell out of this room. You're going to be walking through that a lot because it's the main room. It's almost like I designed the base that way. Huh. And we're getting some pemmican here. Excellent. Peterson is starving. Well, the thing you do then is you go out and you eat a meal. Frail. I think we should be able to get rid of that with Luciferium at some point. But we don't have any Luciferium here now. Not at this point in time, anyway. Strip all the bodies that haven't been stripped yet. There's a lot of clothing currently lying outside. Should be doing more hauling, though, so it should come inside eventually. Yeah, Semyon's doing hauling right now. I might send a... What did I load you with? Some more launchers are under a roof. Okay, so you cannot launch things if they're on a roof. Or rather, if they're under a roof. That makes complete sense. But it's nice to know for certain, you know? Sometimes you just have to forescience it. You're too smart. Yeah, you're an optimist. We wouldn't be able to recruit... maybe kangaroo. Crafting is good, but... you're gonna be too much of a drain on our resources. We'll just strip you, and we'll take your clothing. And then you can go free. We're not vengeful people. We simply want you to stop attacking us all day long. That'd be great. Why haven't you built the wind turbine yet? Damn it, Anna! We needed that to be done ages ago. No wonder we're having power issues here at the moment. Oh dear. Plus side, this colony's starting to look pretty good. I'm still terrible at making the colony work at a decent pace. But it's looking pretty good. I like it. I like it a lot. Impressive hallways and everything. We're nearly done digging this out, so that's going to provide another access point to this lovely trading room that we're going to get. Also making more stone blocks, which is always appreciated. Currently have quite a few. Yeah, we've got 4,200 sandstone blocks. That is impressive. That's going to be worth a lot of money. Probably. A muffalo is miscarried due to starvation. Really? Oh yeah, you're... oh yeah, they're cold. Of course they're starving. Damn it. Right. All the males go inside first. I mean, they're already pregnant, but... just to make sure. Gotta do this by the book. As soon as they wake up, they should be going inside. How are you guys doing? Very slow. A raid. Really? Oh. Wow, that is, five people. We can literally fist fight you 3-1 and win. You've got frag grenades, you've got a heavy SMG, you've got a charge rifle. Hudson. A mafia boss, ooh. Scary, scary. You've got a peg leg. Right, yeah. This is, a nice bunch, I'll be honest, they have good gear. I would love that gear. I don't mind that sniper rifle. I don't mind the assault rifle. Frag grenade? Charge rifle? It's damaged, but hey. Also, may I just point out, they're sending a raid of 5 people over here when the other colony is like, oh yeah, we have 8 people, we don't have a lot of defenses. Send in the tribes. You know, just absolutely murdering everyone. Right, Meritrix, your shooting isn't great. Sugar, we definitely need you. Missy, get over here. Where's James? Right there. Hubbard, get in here as well. Morton, definitely. We'll let the other people just, you know, lick their wounds. So we've got one shield, able to distract people. Hopefully we'll be able to kill all of them. Or take a meatbag prisoner, like, I don't know. Just do whatever. Also, meatbag sounds like a hilarious insult. Just want to say that real quick. We'll probably get rid of the shed outside soon, because I don't like it being here anymore. Gonna reinstall the beds over here. Temporary sleeping barracks. Huzzah. No, that was a misclick. Whoops. Reinstall. Reinstall. There's a barrier bed, so, you know, pretty good beds. As far as beds go, anyway. You can stand over there, probably. Hubbard, I'm gonna keep you at range. Meritrix, the rest close in. But grenades being hurled. No! Boomalope! Why? They weren't hurting anyone! You maniacs! You dare shoot at a buffalo! Oh dear. Jesus! That's a shield gone. Yeah, you need cover now. Don't stand there. Move back. Morton. Move up. I mean, I was joking earlier, but they are sending people to the colony that doesn't have that many defensives set up either. Like, we could fall back, sure. That's probably what we're gonna end up doing. I just didn't want them to hurt my muffalo. Oh, you took a nasty headshot. You seem to be okay, though. Might be time to get out, however. Oh, dear. Morton, move! Oh, God. Yeah, we're running. We're running. Disengage. Ooh, damn, he just got shot by friendly fire, didn't he? I'll take it. Hudson is... Oh, dear, you're dojuicing up. Right, we're gonna fall back to the inner defenses. This is bad. James took a headshot. It's nothing severe. Or at least someone took one. Clara's lost a lung. Yeah, that's old news. We're gonna be just trying to fall back here just to our better defenses. Turns out, should not make fun of these raids if I can't actually beat them in the field. I made a big mistake today. Right, here we go. Everyone's falling back inside now. Including you, James. Get moving. What are they doing? They're doing things. Doing weird things, I'll be honest. Hubbard, get behind a pillar. Missy, flick that turret. Get over here. Tony, what are you doing? You crazy woman! Flip the turret. Nice, chase is down. There's fire. Really? You're setting the horseshoe pin on fire? Have you no honor? It's a horseshoe pin, for crying out loud. Right, you're allowed to do whatever the hell you please. That's a heavy, shoddy SMG. Low quality. Why can you not? Oh, because I didn't tell you to start clicking it. Wow, yeah, okay, that's good. Now we're gonna get out of there, because we want to kill these people. You've got the good weapons that I want. They're gonna try to flee. Let's break days. D.Va is breaking. Everyone's allowed out again. They're gonna get away, aren't they? Damn it. They're gonna get away. Oh, Missy might be able to catch up to Lars, though. Do whatever. Just make sure we don't lose more people. Reese is definitely getting away. I would have loved that's a good sniper rifle. But we should be able to get Lars, though. It's not as bad as it could have been. A Muffalo is miscarried. You should have gotten inside. Like I told you, get inside. Get him! Come on! He's getting away! Despite his peg leg! Aw, Missy! Missy! I'm not happy with that, Missy. Damn it. Right, Morton is currently attacking someone who's already fled. Yeah, don't. Meritrix is in severe trouble here. Get over there, Morton. We actually have the technology to make a pretty decent hospital bed ourselves. Yeah, just make sure people don't die, preferably. Got a lot of injuries, actually. But nothing too serious, thank God. D.Va, he didn't get shot, so that's okay. Meritrix did, though. Thankfully, Morton's here. Morton will be able to save her life. You've already been patched up. You've been patched up, so have you. James will live as well. No immediate danger. So we got out of that with the skin of our teeth. I've learned not to brag. Which is a very important thing to learn. Bragging is bad. Ends up getting your colonists killed. We're never able to take any prisoners, are we? Oh well. Don't really care. They killed my boomalope. They deserve to die. They did bring us frag grenades, though. Frag grenades ain't bad. We can sell those for money. We can sell their apparel as well. Those turrets, man, they're pretty useful. I'm not gonna lie. I thought, you know what? We'll build them. Why not? What's the worst they can do? They're pretty damn helpful. You know, I'm not gonna complain. Also, why are people eating pemmican when we have simple meals? I'm gonna go and delete some zones here. There we go. That's gonna be a special zone. Just happens to be the exact same colored zone, that's okay. Now it looks weird, but we'll fix it in a second. Priority critical. We're not gonna allow any meals in here. We will low pemmican, though. Yes, you know, pemmican's pretty good to store over there. We're only gonna allow meals in here. Doesn't matter whether it's fine meals, lavish meal, nutrient paste. We're not gonna allow packer survival meals, so we'll allow them over here. If we ever get some. But we'll be keeping the meals we want to eat in these three stockpiles. Why do I say three? Well... Wow. That was sad. I was kind of hoping we'd just keep them all, but okay. Copy. Paste. Paste. I'm gonna hide all these. Because, you know, we don't need that to be there. I was gonna hide this one, because we don't need that to be there. Make Rimworld pretty again. That sort of thing. You can hide, you can hide. I just had these unhidden for convenience for a while. There we go, much better. Eventually, we'll put fire breaks in place and whatnot, so it'll actually become very pretty. For now, though, there we go. Rimworld is pretty again. How are you doing, Meritrix? You'll live. Morton's also been treated. Right, so that is nobody dead on today's watch. Good. That would have been really bad, possibly. Wolverine's fully healed. Anna! Rip Wolverine! We're releasing her. You're a female archer. Huh. Interesting. Yeah, there you go. Bye! Enjoy the frostbite! We don't care about you. Get out of our face! I will put the door there, by the way, just so, you know, we don't lose too much heat in here. That said, it's already pretty terrible. Bye, Wolverine. I hope you won't regen all your health back later, because we will definitely shoot you again if you do. Ooh, get a bunch of Link skin. We can make stuff out of that, or sell it, you know? I'm not opposed to earning some money. How's Kangaroo doing? Pretty good. Oh, you got an old gunshot. Interesting. So you're going to be walking slower because of that. Because Wolverine exited the map healthy, relations with the Black Crag Alliance have improved by 15. So yeah, you just don't have to try recruiting them ever. Otherwise, you know, you won't get the relations buff. Stripping them is just fine. Let's have a free charge rifle. Charge rifle's pretty good. Although, it's not quite as accurate. Then again, do we care? I don't think we do, not at this point. Anna failed while building a wall. Damn it, Anna. You're supposed to be the chosen builder here. That's not good enough. Speaking of Kangaroo, you're about healed up, aren't you? Yeah, you're gonna go for a walk soon as well. One shield, fully healed. Cool. Now about this pod here. What did I load you with? You can never check that. It's very annoying. I'm just gonna have to trust. Like, we probably sent over a ton of steel. But I have no way of checking. Expand no roof area. But that is unroofed, huh? I honestly don't have a clue. Yeah, okay, that is unroofed, but it still counts as being indoors. Okay, so only... expand build roof area. Only the pod itself has to be unroofed, probably. Sorry to remove your joy activity there. Yeah, now we can launch again. And hey, we'll probably drop the pod right there. You're like, hey, delivery! Whoosh. I'm not sure what's inside, so it's gonna be a nasty surprise. Hi, everybody! Oh. Oh yeah! The lungs! And Thrumbo Horn, and we broke the roof. Yeah, that's... it's a constructed roof, ironically enough. Yeah, definitely keep that roofed. Anyway, we got some more steel dropped in. That's where all the weight came from. I remember now. Got a bit of wood. Wood's nice. James. Could you, roof it, please? Also, it turns out we kind of damaged our heater by dropping a pot on it. Oh well, that fixes the roofing issue. We now have lungs over here that we can sell if we so choose to do so. Or we can start giving them to people. I'll be honest, I'm tempted to just give James a new pair of lungs, right here, right now. We'd have to have him on Luciferium for like 3 seasons to get rid of it. As soon as Morton is healed, we'll go and take care of that. Hey, James deserves to be asthma free. You're rescuing Boomalope 2. Oh, they don't... oh yeah, they don't have any food over there either. Whoopsie. So where is the animal zones at the moment? Those are for males, so we'll put some kibble in there, and then females should be over here. Yeah, okay, we're gonna store kibble here with critical priority. Hey, apparently they're hungry. I mean, I knew that, but even then, we gotta take better care of our buffalo. And just animals in general. Especially with the snow being outside and whatnot. Sugar is fully healed. Great. People are starting to recover from their injuries. Gonna clear out the debris over there at some point. But yeah. Aside from putting a small dent in our very impressive, beautiful dining hall. That's really good. We need to clean the blood up at some point. That's probably very high on a priorities list. No, blood ain't pretty. Blood ain't pretty. Anything else we want to do? Well, Freezer's still cool, that's good. D.Va's no longer psychotic, that's also really good. Perhaps you can get in bed somewhere. That would be good. Nobody's moving those beds, which is a little bit annoying. We do have someone else on construction here, that would be Firefan, actually. He's getting some more stone blocks, which is, you know, pretty helpful right now. Oh, I see, they just ordered a hand-tailoring bench. Damn. That's where the wood came from. I mean, it was only temporary anyway, but that's one way to make me move it, I guess. Nelly, thank you. Moving the beds so that nobody else has to sleep in this ugly outdoor house anymore. So, D.Va. That's definitely over here now. This is now counted as a barracks instead of a dining hall, because hey, people are sleeping in there. But it's better than sleeping outside, so who cares? Hubbard is gonna make sure the animals have food. Noble calls. I want you to haul the medicine so that we can start demolishing this. Now we're gonna cancel that. Cancel the deconstructing the bed. We wanna move it. Nelly, was it? Yeah. Someone's using that bed. That's annoying. Nelly, you're taming a buffalo? Oh yeah, we haven't gone over their priorities yet. Whoops. Tony can be a doctor if he wants to. We'll have Tony be animal handling, because hey, he's very passionate for it. Dan and Hubbard can both be wardens. Dan and Hubbard can both do handling. We'll also have Tony on handling because he's pretty good at it. Tony can also do crafting. We don't need you to do art. D.Va can do art. D.Va won't do hauling or cleaning, which is a bit of a shame. Don't need you to handle, really. We'll have you hunt, I believe. Yeah, you'll be a fine recruit for the militia one day. In fact, we'll give you a charge rifle right now to prove it. Be very careful with those deadfall traps. I mean, colonists have a very, very, very low chance to trigger them, though. It's like 0.6% or something, but it's still going to happen at some point. You just know it. Morton's fully healed. Good. Guess we'll do the surgery on James, then. Actually, James, could you do me a favor? Furniture. We're gonna build a hospital bed. It's gonna take 120 steel. It's not nothing. Matter of fact, I want you to build two of them. You're level 18 construction. Quality doesn't actually matter. The only thing that matters for quality is like the rest effectiveness they get. But I kind of want to get it high anyway so that people can sleep better. See? Superior. That's good. Now just one more. Now D.Va's gonna lie down. That medical bed, by the way, gives you extra immunity gain speed. A normal bed will give you 110%, so getting in a steel hospital bed makes it even easier to become immune to disease. It also gives you extra base quality treatment, I believe. And we got another superior one. Great. So this should make it easier to give James new lungs. Morton! Prioritize the operations on James. You've got a 101% chance of success, which will be helped by the fact that we're doing this in a medical bed. And we get a... ooh. Combat supplier right here. I would love to chat with you. You've got a bionic eye. Cool. You have a lung. We already have lungs, no thank you. Plasteel maize pork can go get sold. Silver maize, sure. I'm keeping the plasteel spear, it's a good killing weapon. I prefer using the mace though for capturing, because you know, a mace is amazing. It also deals blunt damage instead of like sharp stabbing damage, so it's much better to just incapacitate people with. Downside is, they will occasionally climb back on their feet and try to run. So, you know, capture them quickly. But it's way better for non-lethal takedowns. Which is exactly what I'm trying to do with the Black Crag Alliance. The rest of them, they can die. Anything else worth selling? We'll sell the Goju's. I want to keep the medicine. I actually have a pretty good amount of medicine. That said, we don't need any. Yeah, I think we've pretty much sold everything. I want to keep that pistol for shooting practices. Yeah, we'll sell the personal shield, normal 63%, because it's... Wow. Those are worth a lot. There we go, we got our bionic eye. Cool. We definitely need more eyes. There we go. Eye on the prize and whatnot. How are you doing? 6 days, 6 hours. You've got 8 days of food, wow. 6 days, 21 hours. Despite you being a very fast moving person. What's the terrain like over here? 9.4. Oh, damn it, Morton. Really? I give you a hospital bed and everything, and you fail on James. God damn it, dude. Why? It's like, yeah, we're using 101% success chance doctor. With really good medicine and everything, and yeah. He still fails. Despite having a medical bed as well. For God's sake, Morton. This is a disgusting development. Yeah, we just wasted a lung that we got from someone. Not very happy with that, I'll be honest. If you dare fail a second time, I swear to God. Yeah, you don't need medicine. James does. You kill him, I swear to God. I will never forgive you, Morton. Neither will James, by the way. There you go. So James is able to move faster now, because he's got less breathing issues. But I'm still not very happy with this, Morton. You wasted a perfectly fine lung. Yeah, we'll put a trade beacon over there. What's the range we have here? It's like 6. Should be able to dig that out by 2 more without affecting... Yeah, well, I'll take a look at that like in between episodes, probably. We'll also mine out the silver ore here a bit further. So I like silver ore. We'll deconstruct those limestone walls. They don't seem to be leading anywhere, which is nice. So we'll keep digging more bedrooms over there. Now that we've got Von Shield, we actually have a decent miner here. Which is pretty good. I'm happy with that. Temperature in here is A-okay. I like it. Got some more dead animals here. We're racking up the pemmican. We're doing good. Diva's trying to heal. We finally have some good medical beds, so hey, that helps. We're nearly all back on track. Morton, what is your medicine now? Still 15. Yeah. You need more experience, dude. Or another eye. Although, I'm kinda loath to give you another eye at this point. Just because, you know, we don't have a lot of them. Gotta try and be careful with them. Poor James. He should have been asthma-free at this point. Should have. Would have. Could have. It's no use thinking like that. Let's go and expand a no-roof area over here, just to make sure that we don't get a roof collapsing on our heads. That would be pretty bad. James is fully healed. Meritrix! Take that bed. Yeah, I've got more plants dying over here because of the cold. Just gonna say, this is not going very well over here. Oh, kangaroo, you're fully healed. I didn't notice that in the kerfuffle. Yeah, you're off as well. I don't think you realize, kangaroo. You're not allowed clothing. Damn it. I will win this from you, you know? You won't win. You won't leave with that awful clothing. It's buffalo wool tribal wear. How fitting. Go say hi to Wolverine for me, will ya? Get out of my face. With your right lung injury. He's going to be moving slightly slower because of that. Also means it's easier to crush his lung next time he comes around. If he decides to show his face again. I hope he doesn't. Because it would be awkward at best. Meritrix is fully healed. Good! Hey, people are healing now. You're gonna go hunt more alpha beavers. Well, you do you. I'll have James deconstruct some more stuff here because, hey. Oh! Relations have gone up by plus 15 again. They're still at minus 7, so we could get them off our backs by sending some gifts. They're binging on smoke leaf. How do you want to do that? It's my question. There is no smoke leaf for you to reach. Uh-huh. James is going to get rid of all the roots. Excellent. Just to make sure that when we inevitably bring this all down, it doesn't come crashing down on our heads. Really good at constructing, I'll be honest. That's going really well. Proud of you, James. You're doing extremely well. You might even be able to reach level 20 construction. That would be really good. Like, we're going to make sure you push to level 19 today, if at all possible. I get some cargo pods. Ooh. Psychoid. I love me some psychoid, although we don't really have the facilities to do anything with it. Make more sandstone blocks. Do it! Yeah, I would really prefer if you just keep, like, deconstructing everything right now, James. You're doing so well! Von Shield is building. Von Shield? I don't want you to do construction, Von Shield. Yeah, stop wasting resources, please. Thank you! Diva, what are you doing? You're just wandering. This is why we keep the stuff behind locked doors. Local alpha beaver has gone mad, oh no! I can't prioritize you to hunt it, really. Oh, now I can. What are you doing? Where are you going? Oh, it's following Nelly. Run, Nelly! Yeah, you're fleeing. Damn. Look at that! So close, James! So close! Level 19 is within your reach! I'm sure you'll be able to get it. Dan tamed a buffalo! Named it Buffalo 8. Cool. That's a dead timber wolf. It died to an infection! Oh! Yeah, infections are a pain for animals. I don't know what you were fighting, but... It didn't do too much damage to you, but yeah, you know, infection, it's a silent killer. Oh, wow. Nelly, just shoot him. Oh, you don't have a gun. Well, this is awkward now. You're also not the person I was thinking of. You go, Nelly. Wow. Yeah, you should have been a... You should be fleeing, yeah. You're only a 2 in melee. Well, you'll survive. James, level 19? Yes! Slightly higher chance of building better stuff now. That's good enough for me. And that is where we're going to be leaving it for this episode. I can't help but notice that I've gone overboard for a long time. I'd like to thank you all for watching another episode of Rimworld Alpha 16. We're getting almost close to the new year, like 10 more days. Our caravans are heading home. They're doing pretty good. Pina might be able to catch up. Although, probably not. But that's okay. Pina should be okay without much food. I kind of wish you'd move a little faster, though. And hey, that's the troubles of moving around in the middle of the winter. That's exactly why I caution you against it. I make the mistakes, so that you don't have to. That bear looked angry for a second, my god. Nothing terrifies me more right now than an angry bear. But yeah, if you want to watch more Rimworld, but you are not yet subscribed to the channel, do consider hitting that subscribe button so you will get notified when future videos go live. Until next time, have a good one, folks.